losing yardage. It'll be back at the 36. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Now, that was impressive by the defense. They just got hit for a big pass play, and instead of rushing out and getting back deep to cover, they played their techniques, saw the run develop, and ran to it and made the play.
Now Cutler to throw on second down.
Oh, come on.
There, a nice hit, jars the ball free, and brings up third down. We see this offense, and we see Jeremy Langford, certainly a guy to watch in this game.
He plays a game with great determination, Brandon. In college, he played multiple positions before settling in at running back. He made the right choice.
Now they go screen. It's complete. Oh, he's got a little daylight. Jeremy Langford.
Let's get it, baby. Good shit, Langford.
Chicago. Jeremy Langford, 64 yards. And the Bears have taken the early lead. Well, he's used to running at that distance. Here, he had to catch it, too, before making the run. Heck of a play for the score.
There's not many things better for an offense than a back who is a complete guy, who can run it and catch it. And we just saw him complete a big-time play for a touchdown.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And with a new rule, that decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he only gets to the 20. Austin's got it left side, and they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Now the first carry here for Todd Gurley. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs. And Gurley actually had his second best rushing performance of the season in week 11. Still has
100
yards this year.
My bad. I'll be right back.
Touchdown.
That game qualifies as one of the best ones of the year for him. Still seeking the breakout, as you mentioned. But I know one thing about him. He and the Rams have found quick starts in recent games. It's just being able to sustain throughout that's been the issue for them.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. Now Goff. And a catch made by Kenny Britt.
Nice.
Britt was so good against the Jets a couple of weeks ago, over 100 yards. And then, Charles, he followed that up 43 yards, 5 catches last week.
And his maturity, which continues to increase, they're going to need that now with a rookie quarterback named Jared Goff. They need Kenny Britt to be that target outside that's reliable and that Jared Goff can look to when things are tight. Lance Kendrick's a tight end.
Sorry, man. I had to step away for a minute.
They'll do every gizmo package they can to get the ball in the hands of Tavon Austin.
First touch of the game here for Benny Cunningham. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about 5.
In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
Now the offense in that middle ground here on third down, 3rd and 5.
Goff now looks to throw. And
incomplete. Get that out of there. Good stuff. Let's go, D.
It's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So the Rams call on Johnny Hecker here to punt it away on fourth down. And how about this, a fake? And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were competent enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away. The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk.
All right, guys, I'm back.
And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run,
what we got here,
any spot, because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
On second down, here's
Cutler. Ooh, good stop.
With a great push up front, he picks up the sack and a loss of 8. Now Cutler on 3rd and long. Out to the flat, that's complete to his running back. It's a gain of 5, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Good stop, man.
Down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Come on, guys.
Hits at the 7, but bounds into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Now the Rams offense, they work their way back on the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on 4, turned it over in their own territory, but the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number 1 headset?
Not today.
As a head coach, that was planned going into it. Not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold
it. He trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it. Be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own side.
Now we'll see what his offense can do. Back live now to begin the 2nd quarter with Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon. It's the Rams with a football to get us going, but they face a 2nd and long to start things out. And that is going to set up a 3rd and 1.
All right, here we go.
Goff wants to throw on 3rd and 1. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very
Don't
often.
Do it.
Pretty reliable. Usually an excellent target and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
They'll come out in the pistol.
Told you not to do it.
His decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and the Bears are going to get the football back.
Change up our offense.
Great field position. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. They isolate Jeffrey to the left side. On 1st down, it's Cutler. They go screen play to Langford. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line.
So many things have to come together just right for a screen pass to break for big yardage. The blocking, the timing of the pass to the runner, everything has to fit together just right. But on that play, the defense was able to disrupt things and hold it to a short game.
Now Cutler to throw on 2nd down. Ryle making the catch over the middle. Call it a gain of three. And that'll lead here to a third down. Well, they were handed great starting field position on this drive, but now they face a third and four. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16. 7 yards there, good enough to move.
Good run, Langford.
On third down, that's a good job of situational football and understanding where the first down marker was and getting there.
Now Cutler on first down. And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Matty Royal, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bears will extend their lead. Those are the touchdowns that aren't just scored on Sundays or on Monday night. Those are the ones that are scored during the week because they had that preparation and a great route run.
Oh, I love that observation because you don't just roll out on game day and say, okay, go run this route and let's get it done. That means exactly what you said. The practice had to occur beforehand, which led to the timing, which led to the touchdown.
And his kick is right through.
Let's go, guys. Let's get it.
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. So now here are the Rams as their offense comes back out. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned it to 6 points. So they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
So the offense has it first and 10. Shift together here from the D-line. Goff on first down. Austin's got it left side. And he'll be brought down right at the 45-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down. To throw on second down is gone. Forced out to his left. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up a third down.
And we have to give credit to him for buying time and extending the play. But you know, there's some really upset defenders on that one. They thought that they had him. Instead, he was coated in Teflon and got away.
The 21 yards there as they convert.
Nice.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
Now Goff on first down. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. It'll go as a gain of 10 there. And it'll be a Los Angeles first down. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say,
damn, come on, guys, stop golf.
We can throw it well with a whole lot.
There's play action.
2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Soldier Field following this short break. The one running back is Gurley. They'll get the football here. And running room hard.
Gonna have to hold him for a field goal, guys.
Give him 2 yards on that one. Second and goal now. And they're gonna hurry back to the line now. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably doing play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
Nice.
Sirline's kick is good.
And they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. Well, at least they won't take a goose egg into intermission as they do carve out 3 points here in the waning moments of quarter number two.
Yeah, it hasn't really been the greatest of first halves. They've looked out of
get off me
on the offensive side of the ball. But a field goal here at least gives them some momentum as we tick down toward halftime.
And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
They'll run with Langford to begin the drive. And he'll be tackled at about the 35. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and three. And now the Rams are going to halt things as they want a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Second down following the run. They come out here in the eye. They keep it on the ground with Langford. And unable to. And the Rams are going to go ahead and take another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
I'll take that.
Might have got him.
I'll take that.
This might be a first down. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. This time, Cutler will throw.
Come on, guys. I hate when they get stuck.
I know here because I got to get our man Bernie Beaudry in.
Oh, is that the guy? Right?
Yeah, the audio guy who got demolished by Linval Joseph, 330-pounder for the Vikings running out of the tunnel.
That was something because when I saw him go across and then he got hit, I was thinking about the gauntlet drill we used to run when I was a player. You try to run in a small space and not get tackled. And Bernie didn't quite make it, but here's the best part, though.
Let's go, Jeffrey!
Cutler to Jeffrey on the hook up there. 54 yards. A great job pulling that one in from a guy, as we know, who can really blaze. He's got a lot of speed.
And that speed can work for him so many different ways. Sometimes he just takes off and goes and just runs past people. Sometimes you get people to back off so far that you can catch everything underneath. But still, at some point in the game, you probably have to make some contested catches, right? Sometimes you have to go up and be the defender for the football. He has that in his arsenal as well.
Showed it right there. On second down, Langford. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Bears. Jeremy Langford.
Bear down, baby.
Second touchdown in his first half. And the Bears will add on to their lead. Now Barth for the extra point. It's 21-3.
Smokey Sam 509. Just to give you a heads up, you're getting broadcasted live on a feed, and I just want to let you know, man.
Now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And the Rams now coming out on the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here. All right, Brandon, while we have a quick second here, I've got to come back to the field goal kickers, all right? Last week, we had 12 missed PATs. And I remember talking with a couple of kickers, and they said missing a PAT now with the new rules is way more damaging to their psyche than missing a field goal But they also say when you miss a PAT, there's a carryover about your confidence trying to kick a field goal.
And we saw 12 of them, a league high, missed last week. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. He's going to loft one deep left side here into a double team, and it's intercepted.
Pick City, baby.
And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. The Bears offense now heading back out onto the field, and the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
Nothing on that one. It'll be second down. On second down, Cutler. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Well, they decide to air it out a little bit on that play, take a shot downfield, but the coverage was really nice. Able to get a hand in and tip it away.
And they line up now for what will likely be the last play of the first half.
All right, guys, y'all get open.
Extra defensive back in there on third and 10. Final play of the half. It's Cutler. They go screen play to Langford. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL.
Good head, Smokey.
And it's a presentation of EA Sports. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now out on the field, here comes Los Angeles. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually
is. Let's
go. Create more hype than what is there. But this is a
real,
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Third and four. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Gone. That's complete to Brent.
Hey, come on, man. I should have dove.
Yardage as he brings this up to the 47. A solid gain of 15 yards in the sticks move. They go with Cunningham. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And he takes it across midfield to the 45. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves him with third and just a couple. And the offense moving quickly to the line. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Goff now looks to throw. And he will find his man. It's Kenny Brent. It's a pickup of 15 and a fresh set of downs.
A little football 101 there. You just see the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning he goes right at it.
And no,
yes.
This time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Akeem Hicks in there to get him for a loss of five. Possible run anticipation. Here's the D-line sandwiches together. Here's Goff now on second down. He's got quick.
Ah.
And he'll get
good shit. Good shit. That was my fault.
Rams. Brian Quick. 35 yards. Now whistles and a timeout signaled here by the offense. And that's their first of this second half. Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. It's up and good, and the lead is down now at 11. It's 21-10. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. This is taken at the 3. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
Let's see what we got here. Ooh.
The drive starts with a carry by Langford.
Oh, come on, Langford. Dang.
And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. And the Rams getting set to go now. And they're hoping to capture some of that magic they had last time out when they were able to put together a scoring drive. But they're still down here, Charles.
Not the major concern, though, because of what you talked about. They scored the last time out.
Good drop. Good deep.
They feel like their game plan is now in effect. They know how to attack and what plays they want to put together. But they've got to keep it moving in the right direction because, as you did note, they are down on the scoreboard.
So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Now Goff will hand this one to Gurley. Shreds the tackle. And
nice.
This inside the 30 to about the 29, maybe the 28-yard line.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7. Throwing on 3rd. Gone.
Oh, give me that. Come on, man.
Back into the game. Instead, 4th down. So out comes a field goal team now for the 2nd time here today. He made his first attempt. This from 45. And Zerline's kick is good.
Nice kick.
And high fives for that one as that drive ends in 3. So they recover the fumble but could not take advantage of the short field. They do get 3.
And no one ever turns down 3 points going up on the board, but the offense will go to the sidelines wondering what if, while the defense on the other side, they'll celebrate holding them to just a field goal after giving up such bad field position.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Onto the field now come the Bears. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Cutler to Langford on the draw. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. It's a loss of 2, now 3rd down.
Aaron Donald weighs nearly 300 pounds, but he does have the ability to make himself skinny in a hole, which means it's hard to block him. That's how he gets upfield and makes the plays we just saw. How about that? His 2nd tackle for a loss in this game.
He loses 5 full yards to bring up 4. Here's Pat O'Donnell now.
Good stop, bro.
For his 2nd punt, he'd take a repeat of his 1st. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And this ball's going to be down now right at the 10-yard line. Good spot. The Rams offense now, they get set and head back onto the field. And after the field goal last time, we'll see what they can get here. And at least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I've never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them want to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative.
Hell no, that shit ain't happening again.
A timeout defensively. It's just their 1st, so 2 remaining as they burn 1 here in this 3rd quarter. Now the offense lining up 1st and 10. Now a 1st down, looking for Austin.
Give me that shit. I knew that was going to happen.
Danny Trevathan, and they will take over at the 26-yard line. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency, move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of 1st downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Langford again.
Get off me!
That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary, and that led to a really nice game.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the one. A good run of 6 yards there gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
They come out here in the eye. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Chicago. Jay Cutler scoring on the sneak from a yard out. And the Bears use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here's the Los Angeles offense as they get set to take possession. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. It'll be a gain of 6, and that'll make it a second down.
Back on it up, Billy. Here we go. Set, move, run, gun, gun, gun.
The one running back is Gurley. He'll get it running right. Not much room here as he only gets it to about the 30. A 3-yard pickup on 2nd and 4. Now they'll need to convert here on 3rd and a little more than a yard. And they're going to speed things up here. Goff wants to throw on 3rd and 1. And unable to connect on the long pass. It falls down incomplete.
On 3rd and 1, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there. But they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on 4th down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Desperation time for Goff on 4th. Caught here left side.
Damn. Good play.
Tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. And now they're in the hurry up.
Well, it all came together on that one, didn't it?
Big time throw on 4th.
Now that had to feel good, didn't it? Taking that type of a gamble there and making it pay off. What a throw.
And tough as a receiver, because no matter how perfect the pass, you know it's 4th down and you got to convert.
A little bit of extra pressure, but he overcame it. And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
2nd and 10. Goff again. Got his man over the middle. This is quick. 15 yards through the air and a 1st down. And quickly, they get to the line.
Shut down, shut down. Let's go. Blue 90. Blue 90. Hey, 50.
On 1st down, Goff. And he's going to be intercepted.
Give that to me.
Time. A great read, and it's picked off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
It takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that.
And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And he'll take this one up to about the 23. That's going to be a 6-yard gain. It leaves him with third down and just a yard to go.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved him and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball.
They come out here in the eye. He'll try to run for the first with Langford. And he loses the
come on, Langford.
Second time.
Wow.
Come on, Langford.
But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. This is Langford on first and 10. Room here to run. 17 yards on the pickup there, and the drive will continue.
Another good run there, and now we're seeing an offense that's imposed its will on a defense. When we talk about that all the time, what does it really mean? It means that the guys on the offensive line, they feel like they can do whatever they want. They're in the huddle saying, run it again. Give us another chance to smack someone and create some space. On the defensive side of the ball, not only have they imposed their will against you, you're almost powerless to figure out what you're doing there, but you got to keep your spirit up at the same time, and they're taking that too.
Langford again, busy man this afternoon. Pass the 20, Jeremy Langford, and they do get him down, but he's inside the.
Damn, he slowed down.
Takes him down inside the 5-yard line, and momentum definitely on the side of the guys on offense. And if you're an offensive lineman, you'll love to run the football, especially out in the field where there's some space. But I'll get you in on a little bit of a secret. Those guys like it in tight, too. Because they get matched up and they get to show just how stout they are in a tough situation, they're recommending they run it again.
Had to take Langford out this game, man.
They'll try again with Howard. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. Call it no gain that time, and now it's 3rd and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
And the D has an extra defensive back here on a very important 3rd down.
Definite pass here.
No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave him with a 4th and goal. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom. Quick, and what a terrific play. Hold it.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And that is touchdown, Bears. Zach Miller from 4 yards out. And the Bears will extend their lead.
And to me.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. This will be caught inside the 10. And he is into the end zone to bump the lead up 2 more. And the hands team for the Rams able to secure the football. Well, 4th quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here.
Bear down, baby. Let's go, Bears.
Special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
I play with the Bears all day, every day, 24/7.
Goff on second down. steps away to his left. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. And now the Bears going to signal for another timeout. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. They'll fake the give. Now gone. He's going to let it fly. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
One thing I know from experience is that when the deep ball is thrown and you're the defender, you've got to fight that little bit of panic that emerges. You've got to play the ball really well. It's a 50-50 jump ball play. And guess what? They took a shot. How are you going to win it? And in this case, they managed to get it done.
And this is dropped in.
And that's how we do it. Bear down. That's against Smokey Sam 509.
And Charles, I think when the schedule comes out, all teams, no matter where they're predicted to finish, talk.
All right, guys.
About protecting your home turf.